this is Pastor Sherwood Hamilton from the House of Prayer located in Darlington, South Carolina, on 1349 Rogers Road. We'd like to welcome you to all the services of the Lord held here at 8 p.m. on Friday nights and on Saturdays at 10:30 a.m. as well as 3 p.m. on Saturday. You're welcome to join us as we worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. We are a body of believers that trust God, we trust His Word, and we strive to live by the very words spoken by Him as well as His Son. Many folk question the Bible, but we believe that the Bible contains the very instructions of our God. Mark chapter 9, verse 7 tells us,
"And there was a cloud that overshadowed them."
There was a cloud that overshadowed them.
And the voice came out of the cloud.
His voice said unto them,
"Saying, this is my beloved Son."
This is my beloved Son.
Hear Him.
Hear Him. The voice that spoke out of the clouds said that Christ was His Son. He didn't make no claims to no other man but Christ. And He said concerning Christ that we ought to hear Him. And the reason why we must hear Him, because John 12 and 49 tells us,
"For I have not spoken of myself."
I have not spoken of myself.
"But the Father which sent me."
But the Father which sent me.
"He gave me a commandment."
Gave me a commandment.
"What I should say."
What I should say.
"And what I should speak."
You see, everything that you read and read, it was given instructions by the Father to say these things. And one of the things that the Father gave him to say is found in Matthew chapter 4 and verse 4.
"But he answered and said, it is written."
It is written.
"Man should not live by bread alone."
These are the words of the Father to you and I. Man should not live by bread alone.
"But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God."
But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Now if you are a Christian, if you say you love God, you say that you are born again, you say that you're saved, then you ought to be practicing every word that the Father has left on record for us. All the words of Christ, these are the things that you should be striving for. Now, if you do not believe every word that Christ has spoken, the Father told Christ to say these words. Luke 6 and verse 46.
"And why call ye me Lord, Lord?"
Why call me Lord, Lord?
"And do not the things which I say."
And you do not the things that I say. It's a waste of time. It's a waste of effort. If you're not willing to do what the Father says, if you're not willing to do what Christ says, then it's a waste of time for you to call Him your Lord. So I want you to pray with us as we pray with you, that we both do as Apostle Peter said in 2 Peter 3 and 18. My prayer to you is that your eyes be open unto the word of the Lord, and that your understanding be increased. And I pray you do the same for us. If you cannot come to our services, please pray that we do the will of the Lord. We both have a job to do, and that is be a witness of the truth. And to be able to do that, we have to grow. And 2 Peter 3 and 18 tells us,
"But grow in grace."
Grow in grace.
"In the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ."
In the knowledge. Grow in grace. And in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is my prayer unto you, and I ask you to do the same for us. Go with me, if you will, to Revelation chapter 3 and verse 10.
"Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth."
The Father left on record through our Lord and Savior that it is going to come a temptation that will extend to the farthest part of the earth. No one will be excluded from this temptation. When we look at the word temptation, it means a test of your faith. It also a test of your faith to try to get you to do something that is wrong. And one thing the God of heaven don't want His saints to do, and that is do something that is wrong. Matthew chapter 10, Matthew 24 and verse 12.
And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold.
This hour of temptation will include such a time frame in which Jesus calls an increase in iniquity, meaning lawlessness, meaning men and women by the masses will not be governed by any laws of God, but they only follow, the only law they will follow will be the law of their own hearts and minds.
Amen.
Christ said, because iniquity shall abound, meaning increase, it will grow stronger and stronger. You will find a new church being erected. Amen. Praise God. All across your neighborhood, all across your state. But it will not change what Christ has left on record. Iniquity shall abound. And because it shall abound, he says the love of many
shall wax cold.
Shall wax cold.
All right.
Now this hour of temptation,
amen,
which incorporates an increase in iniquity, yeah, is going to cause the very love of many saints, many people who call themselves Christians, is going to cause their love to wax cold. Yeah. Now, not only will iniquity increase, well, as a result of iniquity increasing, Matthew chapter 10 tells us what's going to happen.
And the brother shall deliver up the brother.
Verse 21 tells us that the brother
shall deliver up the brother to
shall
death.
Shall deliver up the brother
to death.
To death.
Jesus. And the father, the child.
The father, the child.
And the children shall rise up against their parents.
Now I know a lot of folk look at this thing as the natural. But for a moment I want you to look at this from a spiritual eye. Read it again for me, brother.
And the brother shall deliver up the brother to
death.
We're
talking about same men of faith. Delivering up one another, turning their backs on one another.
Deliver up to the brother.
Same ones that abided in truth. The same one that declared they got the Spirit of God are going to turn on one another.
Say that.
One is going to turn on the one that is holding fast to the integrity of God, and he is going to deliver him up
to death.
To death.
Amen.
Go ahead.
And the father of the child.
The father of the child. Now, Apostle Paul said on one occasion, you have not many fathers.
Amen.
You see, he delivered the gospel to the Gentiles, and he declared himself as being a father unto them. You see, when the pastor gets up and speaks unto you the very words of God, and he plants the seed of truth within you.
Go ahead. Amen.
He's in a position, like Apostle Paul says, as a father.
Amen.
The Bible tells us that the father shall turn and shall deliver up the children. You're going to find out that there are going to be many folk that are in leadership positions within that church. That is going to turn their backs or deliver up some of the very people that have been following them.
Amen.
We're looking at a time frame that's coming upon the earth, which will be a temptation that is going to try you,
amen,
as a saint of God, to see whether or not you maintain the course.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 22.
And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake.
The scripture says, you shall be hated. Talking about the ones that are faithful. Talking about to the ones that are always abiding in the works of the Lord. The time frame, this temptation that's going to cover the whole face of earth will be a time frame in which you shall be hated by all men.
But he that endureth to the end shall be saved.
Shall be saved. Revelation chapter 6, Jesus, verse 9. This hatred, Christ already told us that some of us, the brother would deliver up the brother unto death. My God, can you imagine the very man that you said amen to, the very one that you say, hello brother, or praise the Lord, my brother.
Jesus.
Can you imagine an hour coming or a time frame coming in which they will turn on you and deliver you up to a beast-like government? All because you are holding fast to the very words of God Almighty. Revelation chapter 6, verse 9.
And when he had opened the fifth seal.
Listen to what the word of God had left on record for us.
And when he had opened the fifth seal.
Mm-hmm.
I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God.
He saw up under the altar the souls of them that were slain
for the word
for
of God.
The very word of God. You've been reading your Bible. You know Stephen was murdered. His clothes thrown down at the feet of Apostle Paul. But Apostle Paul later will repent because he done it out of ignorance. Paul later, he would die. Why? For the very word of God. All the patriarchs, the apostles, amen, all the martyrs, many have died for the very word of God. But look what the scripture says. See, that happened in the early beginning of the church. And some folks think, well, that time frame, amen, praise God, would just apply to them. But look what the word says.
And when he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, how long, O Lord, holy and true, doest thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth?
Watch this.
And white robes were given to every one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was said unto them that said that they should rest yet for a little season.
Rest for a little season.
Until their fellow servants also and their brother that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled.
You see, this persecution of the saints of God does not stop there. But the Bible tells us to know that there will be more martyrs in the future.
Jesus.
In this hour of temptation, there are going to be more true saints of God that are going to lose their lives for the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the name of Almighty God.
Amen.
They're going to give up their lives.
Amen.
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 Somebody's behind all of this, brother.
All
right. Revelation 19 and verse 20. The Bible says that we shall be headed by all men for the name's sake. And the brother's going to deliver up the brother. The father's going to deliver up the children. Everyone, not everyone, but a lot of folk are going to turn their back on God. And there is somebody behind it all. Revelation 19 and verse 20.
And the beast was taken.
And the beast was taken.
And with him, the false prophet.
You see, the people were delivered up to a type of beast government.
Amen.
A type of leadership. A leader, amen, praise God, described as a beast. And he was what?
And the beast was taken.
Taken.
And with him.
With him.
The false prophet that wrought miracles before him.
Yeah.
With which.
Wait a minute. There was a beast.
Amen. And the beast was taken. And with him, the false prophet.
And there was a false prophet.
False prophet.
You see, there's going to be somebody.
Amen.
That's going to orchestrate, amen, this rebellion, amen, this turning point in which normal church-going folk are going to start turning their back and start hating the very men and women of God. Somebody behind it all, amen, who's called in the Bible declares him as the false prophet. A religious figure, a religious individual. Who is going to convince the masses of people, amen, that those who abide by the very laws of the Almighty God are worth being turned in to be killed. Daniel chapter 7 and verse 25. This false prophet, amen, praise God, he along with Satan, up under the direction of Satan, he has been trying for a long time.
Amen.
To change some things. And in our lifetime, right now, we have seen in our country, the United States of America.
Amen.
We have seen a great change.
Amen. Amen.
Right here in our country.
Amen.
Daniel 7:25.
And he shall speak great words.
He shall speak great words.
Against the Most High.
Against the Most High.
And shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
He shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
And to think to change times and laws.
Mm.
And they shall be given into his hand until a time and time and the divide of time.
So you see 3.5 years.
Amen.
This false prophet gonna be at work.
Amen.
And some are not going to make it through this hour of temptation. Give me 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. Now the Bible tells in Revelation 3:10 that God said, I also will keep thee from the hour. But I want you to see how bad this hour is going to be.
Right.
Oh yes, God's going to keep some. But this hour is going to be so dramatic. This hour is going to be so trying.
Amen.
This hour is going to be so tempting.
Amen.
That the masses of the folk are going to turn on one another.
Amen.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 1.
Now beseech you, brother.
I beseech you, brother.
By the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
By the coming of our Lord.
And by the gathering together to him.
Yeah.
That ye be not soon shaken in mind.
Don't be soon shaken in mind. Please listen to what these next words are going to say to your hearing.
That you be not soon shaken in mind.
Amen.
Or be troubled.
Or troubled.
Neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter as from us.
Mm-hmm.
As that the day of Christ is at hand.
The day of Christ is at hand.
Let no man deceive you.
Let no man deceive you.
By any means.
By any means.
For that day shall not come, except there shall come a falling away first. And that men of sin be revealed.
You see this hour of temptation. Temptation again is to cause you to do something wrong. It's a testing of your faith. Amen. It's an event that's going to cause you, amen, to do one or the other. Cling closer to God or turn your back on God. Give me 2 Kings chapter 5. This hour of temptation that's coming upon the face of the earth. One of the things that's going to take place during this time. We already see the shadow of it right now creeping inside of the churches. 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 22.
And he said, all is well.
Listen.
My master has sent me, saying, behold, even now there be come to me from Mount Ephraim two young men of the sons of the prophet. Give them, I pray thee, a talent of silver and two chains of gold.
Here is the servant of Elisha. Uh-huh. Amen. Praise God, Gehazi. Amen. Praise God, running down Naaman. Amen. Praise God, and look what he does. Verse 24.
And when he came to the tower, he took them from their hand and restored them in the house. And he let the men go, and they departed.
After speaking with Naaman and gotten the silver, amen, praise God, the silver in the two bags and the two changes of garments, he goes back to the tower and he hides these things. But listen to the words of the prophet in verse 26.
And he said unto him, when not my heart with thee, when the man turned again from his chair to meet thee, it is a time to receive money.
Is it a time to receive money?
And to receive garments.
And to receive garments.
And all of y'all.
And all of y'all.
And vineyard.
And vineyard.
And sheep.
And sheep.
And
oxen.
And master.
And servant.
And maidservant.
And maidservant. Is this the time?
Amen.
See, this hour of temptation, people are going to be focusing on themselves and trying to, amen, praise God, pack their pockets.
Amen.
Can't you see it going on right now?
Amen.
But I say unto you, like the prophet of Elisha say, is this the time for that?
Amen.
You see, this is what's going to cause many people, amen, praise God, to turn on one another. Trying to build up their own little finances in a world in which Christ Jesus is going to destroy. Revelation 3:10, he said, I will keep you from the hour of temptation. Christ is speaking to a faithful few. That Philadelphia church.
Amen.
Those people, scripture tells us, he said, because thou hast kept the word of my patience.
Amen.
I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation.
Amen.
Are you keeping his word? Are you living by every word that proceed out of the mouth of God? If you are, he is going to keep you from this terrible hour. I'm Pastor Sherwin Hamilton. Be blessed and come back.
Amen.
In the hour of temptation.